Good evening. It's a system at breaking point. The pressure on COVID testing sites across Sydney has forced several to close, causing enduring chaos for those urgently needing results. And despite pleas from our government, Queensland won't budge on the negative test requirements for travellers before they arrive.
One of our busiest testing clinics closed, a direct victim of a major pathology bungle. This Bondi Beach drive-through is run by St Vincent's Pathology, SIDPATH. It incorrectly advised 400 COVID-positive people they were negative on Sunday, another 950 prematurely told they were negative yesterday, 486 were actually positive. This was closed to help SIDPATH catch up, the Health Minister rightly concerned.
But I've also spoken to the chief executive of that private hospital and made sure that they have reviewed their protocols and procedures, and he's given me that guarantee.
It's a clear example of a system in crisis. You shouldn't have to sleep in your car to get a COVID test, but it's just what Lynn Kirkcaldy did to be first in line, desperate to get a negative PCR test to return to work.
And it's just 3-hour lines and then you get turned away. So I decided to do this, much to the worry of my family, saying you're out here on your own in Lumia car park.
Across Sydney, testing clinics were closed despite being declared open online. At Hunters Hill and Hornsby, empty tents and barriers up. But elsewhere, the waiting game was back in force. At Roselands, a snaking river of cars stretching for kilometres.
We first went to Concord, it was shut. We then went to Burwood, it was shut. And we got here this morning at about 5 o'clock.
The Premier seeming to dismiss the many reasons people are enduring this.
We are still seeing many people in those queues who do not need to be there.
The Health Minister blames other states requiring a PCR test for entry, targeting Queensland's Premier with a plea to reconsider.
She's indicated that she will revisit it on the 1st of January. That may not seem like a lot of days for her, but it is a lot of days here in New South Wales.
Nothing from the Queensland Premier, but her Health Minister says while day 5 tests will be scrapped, pre-arrival PCR tests will stay for now.
There will be many of people who have got that PCR test interstate and found out they're positive who haven't come here because of that, and I'm aware of some examples. So it is really important that pre-arrival test occurs.
Caught out by that, Lloyd Bennett. He has a flight to Cairns in a couple of days, which requires a PCR test within 72 hours of departure and risks losing thousands if he can't fly. So yesterday, he went to a clinic in Scone, closed. Musselbrook, also closed. Closed Singleton, turned away at Cessnock, then Currycurry, closed. West Pennant Hills and Castle Hill, closed. Returned to Castle Hill at 6 this morning, only to be turned away. The line was too long at Rouse Hill, South Windsor was closed, Richmond was closed, Winmalee had a 4-kilometre queue, and finally, after 12 clinics and 1,000 kilometres...
So then we've come down to Penrith and here we are sitting in the queue trying to get into Dudley's Man.
And that's the story across New South Wales. People started lining up at the bigger hospital testing clinic before 5 a.m. for its 9 a.m. to midday opening and were still turned away.
How many cars have you been turning away?
A lot.
The Premier says rapid antigen tests are the answer.
We've put an order in already for 20 million rapid antigen tests. My expectation is that they will be available by the end of January, and we are doing more in that space as well.
Nine News understands that one option being considered is to make those tests available free in pharmacies and possibly supermarkets. New cases were down again today to 6,062. The number in hospital has jumped to 557, and 60 are in intensive care, up 5. An unvaccinated man in his 80s from Western Sydney is the latest death. Rules are also being modified for thousands of healthcare staff to get them back to work sooner. Close contacts will be able to return after 7 days with a negative test instead of 14 days. Casual contacts can return with a negative test on day 2. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.
And it's not just tourism testing causing those long queues. Pregnant women and new mothers are among the thousands of people forced to wait hours for a swab. Maternity wards across Sydney are asking them to provide a negative PCR test before entering every 72 hours, a requirement many want to see scrapped.
First-time parents with double the joy.
But when Katrina and Donald's identical twin boys arrived 7 weeks early, they found themselves caught up in a testing nightmare.
There's not even enough words.
Tiny Mumford and Murphy have spent their first 12 days in the neonatal intensive care unit at the Children's Hospital at Westmead, and their exhausted new mother needs a PCR swab every 72 hours to be by their side, forced into testing queues that take hours to get through.
We went there at 4 o'clock today at 4 a.m. I had to do my lactation in the car.
Dozens of other families in the same predicament.
I think about us going to go get a test, and I think about them because I know that it's not just me.
It's not only new mothers but expectant ones too. Sophie Burnett, 37 weeks pregnant with twins, forced to wait 5 hours in a car for a test on Boxing Day in preparation for giving birth tomorrow.
There's a lot of sitting. I ran out of water very quickly, and obviously there was nowhere for me to, go to the toilet, which was another issue that we faced. But yeah, it was a long 5 hours.
Many private maternity wards asking women to get a PCR test every 72 hours from 38 weeks pregnant.
No one who is pregnant should be sitting in long queues. I spoke to the health minister this morning and asked him to fix it. My understanding is it is getting fixed today.
We are now in the era in this pandemic of rapid antigen tests making more sense in many cases than PCR tests.
But as the government pleads with people not to join queues unless they have symptoms, there are still dozens of valid reasons people are forced to get tested.
Travel back from overseas needed to get the 6-day test.
In the last week, how many hours is that waiting in lines altogether? 5.5 hours, over two different tests just because he came back from overseas.
Overseas arrivals are contributing to these long, snaking queues. The health minister today saying he's in talks with the Victorian and federal governments to try to wind back testing requirements for international arrivals.
We'd also like them to have a look at cancer patients because we feel they are very vulnerable people and we don't want them in a queue for hours on end waiting to get tested.
Patients needing surgery or specialist appointments, along with visitors to some nursing homes, are also among those directed to join queues.
I just have to go and visit some folks, that's all. So I just had to make sure I'm clear.
All adding pressure to a system already buckling at the knees. Liz Daniels, Nine News.
And Liz joins me now in the studio. And Liz, you have an update for new and expectant mothers regarding those PCR tests.
That's right, Georgie. New South Wales Health has intervened, telling all public maternity wards to scrap asymptomatic PCR testing requirements. And they've asked the private sector to do the same. As for Katrina and the other mothers with children in hospital, they'll now be offered rapid antigen tests on arrival rather than waiting for those PCR tests. The Western Sydney Local Health District says this is about getting the balance right to protect those very vulnerable little ones, Georgie.